Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Around the world, a wave of massive construction projects is reshaping the future. From California's $130 billion high-speed rail to Saudi Arabia's ambitious Line City, we've been watching these developments for years. But beyond the headlines, other breathtaking mega projects are quietly transforming our planet. Take China's Xiongan Smart City, for example, a $95 billion investment built from the ground up in just 7 years. Over 3,000 buildings have risen, and the city features digital roads that collect real-time traffic data and calculate optimal emergency routes. These are not just construction projects, they are building the future. China is known for its ancient history and booming economy, but perhaps the most astonishing thing is its incredible speed of construction. While the US high-speed rail faces decades of delay, and Saudi's Line City remains largely on paper, China has turned barren land into a futuristic city at breakneck pace. This $95 billion mega project didn't just build skyscrapers, it laid down roads that can think. These smart roads calculate the fastest routes for emergency vehicles automatically. And this is only the beginning. China's ongoing mega projects are redefining the scale of modern infrastructure. So here's the big question. How is China building so fast? And how will these projects shape the global future? Today, we explore China's most mind-blowing mega projects, projects that are not only changing cities, but global standards. China has already done what many thought impossible. It's building a $95 billion smart city on the flat plains of Hebei and doing it at breathtaking speed. This is Xiongan New Area, a second capital hub designed to relieve Beijing of its non-core functions. Spanning over 2,000 square kilometers, the city is planned as a high-tech, green, intelligent, and livable urban space. Unlike traditional cities, Xiongan was designed from scratch, both above and below ground. Underground, there's a complete transportation and utility system. Above ground, the city emphasizes nature and open green spaces. The infrastructure blends subways, high-speed rail, water systems, power grids, and 5G networks, all into one ecosystem. Its thinking roads, powered by 5G and IoT sensors, monitor traffic in real time, adjust signals dynamically, and can even calculate optimal emergency routes. Imagine a fire truck getting all green lights to reach the scene in record time. That's not science fiction. That's happening now. While other countries debate whether to build, China is already focused on how to build better. This difference may define the race for the future. Next, let's shift our focus to a completed mega project in China. Not just a transportation hub, but what many call the largest high-speed railway station in Asia. Xiongan Station. This is not just a train station. This is a 60,000-ton steel masterpiece, a mega project where high-speed rail meets futuristic architecture, built not just to transport people, but to showcase the future of infrastructure. Construction began in December 2018, completed by December 2020. In just 2 years, China completed what the world thought was impossible. China's incredible engineering doesn't stop at building cities. It also extends to the movement of water on a national scale. While southern China has abundant water, the north faces chronic shortages. To solve this imbalance, China launched the most ambitious water transfer project in human history, the South to North Water Diversion. With a staggering $120 billion investment, this project spans over 14,000 kilometers, equivalent to building a waterway from Beijing to Egypt. The central route alone crosses the Yellow River and the rugged Taihang Mountains, posing extreme engineering challenges. Hundreds of pumping stations, reservoirs, and tunnels had to be built. And to protect the water source, nearly 400,000 people were relocated. Today, over 10 billion cubic meters of water flow northward each year, bringing vital supply to Beijing, Tianjin, and beyond. This is not just an engineering feat, it's a national lifeline. The South to North Water Diversion Project is the world's largest interbasin water diversion project. It has the world's largest aqueduct system, transporting water from up high. The longest of them reaches 9 kilometers in one stretch, so that it is not affected by the surface environment. It employs the world's largest pump station group. Designed in 13 cascades, the pump stations lift water stepwise and send water from Yangzhou all the way to the southern bank of the Yellow River. Numerous water interchanges high and low are built. Some cross the Yellow River beneath its riverbed. Some stride the Huaihe River from above. Major rivers that are vastly apart now meet with each other. Thanks to the automated facilities that equip the entire route, this grand project is able to navigate through 8 provinces and a major river basins, diverting water over 2,000 kilometers cumulatively in an orderly manner. 9 years into its full operation, water sufficient to fill up the entire Yellow River has been diverted to North China, meaning that 170 million people in 44 cities now use water from the Yangtze River. Today, empowered by modern technologies, China are reshaping rivers like never before, and even create new rivers on this very ancient land. Beyond water, China is now tackling some of the harshest terrain on Earth with the construction of the Sichuan-Tibet Railway, a mega project across glaciers, earthquake zones, and towering mountains. This 1,959-kilometer railway links Chengdu and Sichuan to Lhasa in Tibet. It crosses 14 active fault lines and numerous snow-covered peaks. Engineers face extreme altitudes, frigid temperatures, avalanches, landslides, and earthquakes, all in one project. Some sections exceed 4,000 meters above sea level. Building a single tunnel can take 5 years or more, but once complete, this railway will cut travel time from 36 hours to just under 13. It's more than a transportation line. It's a symbol of China's determination to push the limits of engineering. And the world is watching as this miracle unfolds. So why can China build these colossal projects in just decades, while many Western countries spend years debating a single subway line? The answer may lie in policy execution, integrated supply chains, and a bold long-term vision for infrastructure. China doesn't wait until every problem is solved before starting. It starts and solves problems along the way. In China, infrastructure isn't just an economic tool, it's a national strategy. Each rail line, tunnel, and bridge represents a vision for the future. Of course, these projects come with their own challenges, from environmental concerns to resettlement and social equity. But one thing is clear, China is redefining what's possible through action. In the future, global competition may not be just about technology, but about who builds faster, smarter, and with greater resolve. For decades, China's infrastructure development has been nothing short of astonishing. Bridges rise like bamboo shoots after rain, leaping across canyons, spanning vast rivers, and linking regions once divided by nature. They've transformed not only how people travel, but the very geography of the nation. From Chinese roads to Chinese bridges, from colossal tunnels to massive dams, from high-speed rail cities to vast underground networks, China's engineers continue to break world records, one project after another. These national icons power the nation's economy with unstoppable force. The world is still the same world, but China is no longer the China of the past, where there are mountains, roads are carved. Where there are rivers, bridges rise. With courage and mission, Chinese engineers turn the impossible into reality, again and again. At this point, many American viewers might be wondering, is China already a developed country? Then why does the US government still refuse to officially recognize it as such? Why do Western media outlets constantly amplify the China threat narrative? And why do global research reports often rank China as the world's number one in so many fields? The answer is simple, because China has become powerful, and it did so with astonishing speed. A country once written off as an agricultural backwater is now emerging as a global industrial powerhouse. And that transformation happened in just a few decades. To the world, that's not just growth, it's a shockwave. Seeing China grow stronger and stronger, the United States is starting to panic.
I am stunned to hear some of the rhetoric coming from the other side around a bill that finally, after decades, recognizes that we are in a very stiff competition with China. And for the longest time, America didn't know it. China was in this competition. China was doing everything they could to dump steel in our country. They spend 7 to 9% of their GDP on infrastructure every year. They got islands in the South China Sea. They told us they weren't going to militarize them. Now they have. They have bases in Africa, long-term raw material contracts in African countries to solidify their control of precious metals so that our phones, our weapon systems, our computers, they have a plan. This is not complicated, but it's being seen through the prism of our current broken, insane political system. And so what we're trying to do here is recognize that they're winning. China has a 10-year plan, 50-year plan, 100-year plan. We live in a 24-hour news cycle talking about Dr. Seuss, Big Bird, M&M's, SpongeBob, and we're getting our clock cleaned.
China's strength didn't happen by luck. China's rise is one of the most dramatic national transformations since World War II. It carved roads through mountains and built bridges across rivers. And in that relentless pursuit of progress, China earned a nickname that shook the world, the Infrastructure Maniac, demolishing a bridge in just 25 hours, upgrading a major train station overnight. The speed of Chinese infrastructure builds is unmatched and nearly unbelievable. But there's more to it than just speed. China's engineering marvel even made headlines in the UK, where a popular TV show sparked heated debates about the project while using it to roast their own country's notoriously inefficient railway system.
How the Chinese do these things. And I noticed that they were able to build a whole new station in the space of 9 hours by flooding it with thousands of workers. We should be much more imaginative about getting infrastructure in quickly instead of condemning people to being isolated in remote areas.
Mel and I shared a taxi coming here, and the commentary I can tell you in the taxi was that the roads looked better than the area where we were living in England.
I'm delighted to hear it.
I have to say it was much better than in Buckinghamshire, but everybody in their own area complains. And the truth is our road repairs have been very, very bad, and it's deteriorating. And yes, austerity has prevented expenditure on all sorts of things that we could need to spend money on. But equally, if we cannot borrow...
China now has over 143,000 kilometers of expressways and 30,000 kilometers of high-speed rail, both world records. From remote villages to booming cities, the entire country is connected by a vast and seamless transportation web. To build that, China had to overcome extreme terrain, geological complexity, and ecological challenges. And it did, again and again. Take the Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge, for instance. At 55 kilometers, it's the longest sea-crossing bridge on the planet. Engineers call it the Mount Everest of bridge building. And yet, China built it, under tight constraints, with unmatched precision. This isn't just speed, it's engineering power. Behind the nickname Infrastructure Maniac lies more than just engineering power. It reflects decades of scientific innovation, bold planning, and the will to execute at scale. Each bridge, tunnel, and highway is not just concrete, it's progress. And that progress is meant to serve the people. Infrastructure isn't just about concrete and steel. It carries the hopes of a people, the dreams of a better life. On this ever-advancing journey, China's infrastructure fanatics will keep pushing forward, driving the great vessel of China steadily through the waves of the future. Thanks for watching. Want to know China's next mega project? Subscribe and find out in our next video.